Hello everyone, my name is Brett Bensinger and I'm a Senior Escalation Engineer supporting Windows Phone and Windows Store application development at Microsoft. Today's video blog is a quick walkthrough on how you can easily add a loading screen to your Windows Phone application using data binding and behaviors in Blend. The scenario I'm focusing on for this blog is an application that loads data that may take some time to obtain, and you want the user interface to display some indication while the data is being loaded. Once the application data is ready, it transitions from the loading screen to the screen displaying the data. The sample application I've put together is fairly simple, and I'm using the Model View View Model pattern. I simulate loading data from a web service by calling a web service that will wait 10 seconds and then send a 200 response. This will be sufficient for the purpose of this video blog, which is focusing on the user interface and not the application logic. Here's our sample application called Splash Screen. It's a very simple application in Visual Studio 2013 that has a simple view model and a view model locator. The view model contains the data loaded property, which is a Boolean. A value of true indicates the data is loaded. A value of false indicates it is not. The status property is a simple string where we'll populate the HTTP status response we get from our sample web service call, which is done in the load view model data routine. The other piece is the view model locator, which exposes our main view model through the main property on the view model locator. This is created as a static resource in our app.xaml file, so any page in our application can access the view model locator and obtain a view model from it. In this case, our mainpage.xaml sets its data context equal to the main property off of our view model locator. And our mainpage.xaml only has a simple text block that will display the status from our view model. So now that we've introduced this simple application, let's run it to see how it works without a loading screen. Right now, the data is in the background loading. However, there's no indication that this is taking place, so the user may not be able to use our application. And after 10 seconds has transpired, we should see the status show up on the screen like that. So basically, that's what we're going to change in this video blog. We're going to enter a splash screen, create that in Blend, and wire it up to trigger off of the binding to our data loaded property on our view model. So let's stop the application and open the mainpage.xaml in Blend. You can do this by right-clicking mainpage.xaml in Visual Studio and choosing Open in Blend. Creating the loading screen will be done in three parts. First, we will create the visual we want to see when data is loading. Second, we will create a visual state group to define a loading and data loaded visual state. And finally, we will add a data state behavior and bind it to our data loaded property. The first thing we need to do is to create what we want to see when the data is loading. To do this, I'll use a stack panel that contains a progress bar and loading text. I'll add the stack panel at the same level as the content panel, and then to that I'll add the progress bar and the text block. We want the stack panel to take up the entire screen, so we need to change a couple properties on it. First, we need to make sure it spans both rows, then we'll set the auto width and the auto height property, and we'll stretch it. And lastly, for the stack panel, I want to give it a background color so it stands out and covers up the main screen. I'm going to just choose a dark green here with a gradient brush and give it a little bit of a gradient here. Next, we want to position our loading text and the progress bar towards the middle of the screen. So for the progress bar, we'll set its top margin halfway down the screen. And we'll also set the isIndeterminate property to true. This means that the loading dots that come across the screen will always be there. Lastly, we want to change some properties on the text block, starting with centering it. I'm going to change the font. Be the same as the font we're using for our status text on the main screen. And for that one, I used Britannic Bold. And then I'm going to set the font size to 72 and change the text to loading. And let's give the text a different color as well. Keep it in the green theme here. I think I was somewhere around here. Maybe change the gradient as well. So this is basically what it will look like when data is loading. It's just something really simple we put together. That's pretty irrelevant. You can create this to be whatever you would like. And the next step, what we'll do is we'll add our visual states to control whether data is loading or not loading and what the view of our page looks like in each one of those states. The next step is to create our visual states. We do this from the States tab in Blend. First thing you need to do is create a visual state group, which I will call data states. Then we'll have two different states, one for the loading state and one for the loaded state. When you choose each of these states, basically it'll record the properties and values you want for this specific visual state. For the loading state, we don't want the content panel to be displayed, so we'll set it to collapsed. But for our stack panel we created, this is the screen we want to see when we're loading data. So we want to make sure the opacity is 100% and this visibility is set to visible. Now once the data is loaded, we want the splash screen to go away. So we'll set its opacity to 0 and the visibility to collapsed so we can see the main screen. And that basically sets up what it looks like between the two states. If we have transition preview on, we can see what it looks like to transition from the loading to the loaded state. And by default, it's just going to be an abrupt change. To fix that, we'll add a transition, and we'll choose just a very simple curved easing function, and let the transition take 2 seconds. And what that looks like with that is a little bit different and a little more easing on the eyes. It fades away. Now that we have our states and transitions taken care of, let's turn off recording. And the next step we need to do is to hook up our view model's data loaded property so that it controls the visual states in our UI. To do this, we add a data state behavior to our page. The behaviors can be found on the Assets tab under Behaviors, and in this case, we'll add the data state behavior to our page. We'll bind the data state behavior to the data loaded property on our view model. The value of the data loaded property we will trigger our state changes on is false. So when our data loaded property value is false, meaning the true state, we want the visual state to be set to loading. And when the data loaded property is true, meaning a false state, we want the visual state to be set to loaded. This is all we need to do in Blend to take care of our splash screen. So let's go ahead and save our work and go back to Visual Studio and run the application. We made some changes, so we have to choose to see those changes in Visual Studio. And let's run the application. This time around, we should see our splash screen while we're loading the data. And after about 10 seconds, which is how long it takes the web service to return a 200 response, we should see a transition to the loaded state. That's pretty much it for this video blog. You can use these data states for more complex scenarios as well. For example, a game screen that wants to show scores between levels while the next level is loading, or something similar like that. Lastly, the following slide has some good resources on a couple things we used, including the model view, view model pattern, as well as Blend. I hope that this video blog helps in your application development, and have fun coding.